Good morning, everyone. I am Oracle Unicorn, and welcome to Shaman Messages. Please keep in mind this is a general reading. Take what resonates, leave the rest. Put some things in your back pocket. You never know how you might need it for later. And please check your moon, Venus, and rising sign, as my videos do cross-connect with each other. So there may be some messages in this video for you and also in the other videos for you as well that lines up with your chart. Don't forget to like and subscribe. Subscribing greatly improves the channel. And if you'd like a personal reading with me, the information is below. And if you would like to donate to my channel, the information is in the description box below as well. This is a weekly reading for Sagittarius. and please do keep in mind if this weekly reading doesn't resonate with you, because these energies do extend out longer than a week. I just do weekly readings to try to hit more people than just, you know, half of maybe who it may resonate. So last week may resonate with you better, or next week may resonate with you better, or this week may resonate with you better than next week resonates. Okay, so just definitely keep that in mind, but also be aware that there may be some little messages here and there in here for you, and maybe not the whole story may resonate with you. Okay. And so, yeah, weekly reading for Sagittarius. Sagittarius, interesting. If you have Gemini in your chart, or if you are dealing with a Gemini, I would definitely watch the other video that I just did, because there's a lot of cross-connecting with this video that I also just did with the other video, because there's like already I see three cards that are the same from this video, and I always like, you know, separate the whole deck. And you've seen some of these that flip over on themselves. So, like I've been saying, my videos do cross connect with each other when it comes to messages, and you are coming into a serious amount of balance with blessings and wishes coming in for you, and expanding your own sense of freedom and adventure with your imagination, and to catch your breath, because there is a sudden event of change happening, and to relax within this change, that there is a bountiful harvest happening and a lot of blessings happening for you within this change, okay? And to not take this change too much to heart. Yeah, support. You're gaining support, you're giving yourself support, you have a lot of support with you, and open up, ideal course of action. I swear, y'all might be dealing with a Gemini, or you have Gemini in your chart. Because there's a really beautiful, oh my gosh, acceptance of love. There's a really beautiful story in Gemini that I extended out, a story of love. So maybe that is what's going to possibly be imprinted within this video too. I'm not gonna like re-say that whole story, unless certain parts of it maybe resonate with me to say right now, so. You are coming into balance with the abundance within yourself and what you truly have to give, and adventuring out into really enjoying and being happy within love, which is an ideal course of action, with opening up your heart in the new things, with the new changes that are happening in your life that are helping you to really expand your awareness and your experience in life, and helping you to really be more open with your heart chakra when it comes to your omens and connecting with nature and the gifts that the gifts of download that nature has for you, and to delight in this, because it's really it has, I feel like that you're going to come in to see the beautiful harvest of how much love and extending your heart really does matter. Oh man, y'all have got to watch that Gemini video, because I really think it's going to help. And as it being a wish come true, this extension of love to you, or this extension of love and care you are giving out. Amara. And open up, opening also up to seeing past the illusions that you thought were there. It was just helping you to heal certain matters within yourself of your heart, and balancing your emotions and your heart out, understanding the natural wisdom with connecting to the energies of the universe or whatever it is that you believe in, and being able to see more of the omens and messages all around you, and having clear sight more in your adventure and endeavor with enjoying the experience of life, okay? And you're really opening up your wings, because you got wings in almost every one of these freaking cards. Opening up your wings and allowing yourself to receive unconditional love, and allowing yourself to give unconditional love without expecting too much back in return for being giving. And showing you how you get an emotional, infinite amount of blessings reflected back to you over being giving in that sense with your love and compassion, and seeing how it can really open you up in that sense of being, feeling, when it comes to support and aid from friends and friends that you consider as family. And seeing the growth and the sun rising for you beyond all the hard trials that you've went through, and how much gifts you are being given over the awareness of these hard times that you have went through, and how it has helped you to be able to grow your own sense of awareness and soul, and awakening of the care in your heart, awakening of being able to accept love and give out love. It's like the awakening of the freedom it gives you. It's like you have having a quick shift in your discernment about how you had sight or a projection of thoughts on your trials and the hard times that you did go through. It's like a complete like 180 turn of how you see it now, and being able to be thankful more for it because of the hidden knowledge behind it that it grants you, and how it brings you into a motivation of joy. an enlightened soul growth and motivation of joy, as in, like, yeah, you don't, I mean, I don't feel you don't want to go through more trials over it, but you'll be able to handle these difficulty times differently with more calmness because of this new understanding that is being shifted in your mind, being like really opened up with your eyes, okay? And it's like you gain more patience with this breaking down of illusions and disillusions, and with the projection and the way you see things, it's being broken down to show you how you had imaginary fears and how blocking your heart chakra really held you back, and this sense of really connecting with your heart chakra and listening to what is true for you within your own discernment of what brings a sense of peace to you, and being able to see what you truly do have to offer when it comes to being kind, being just a simple ear for someone to vent without too much of, like, telling that person what they need to do when it comes to healing, or, I mean, you're just allowing them to, and you're transmuting that energy instead of taking that energy on. I feel like you used to take that on as kind of like a burden, and now you're like allowing it to be shifted into like a energy shift of healing, not just healing for that person, but that doing this and having more of a sense of awareness with yourself and the gift that you are giving with doing this shifts healing into yourself, to where it's no longer a burden you're taking on, but that it's opening your heart chakra up more to healing past wounds, to healing healing the impulsiveness that used to hold you back, giving your own self a sense of nurturing and receptive principle within this complete way of seeing, because you got the topsy-turvy shift card and growing into more childlike sense of joy and love and playing within your experiences, but also a renewal of peace within these cycle shifts, because you're coming into the cycle of the shift. Strength of the depth of your own ancient wisdom within, really opening your eyes to accepting this new view, alchemical shift of way of healing. Okay, it's a different way of healing, and instead of having a feeling as if kind of like a thought of giving healing just to that person to be there, you're seeing how it is shifting healing, not just for that, like I said, not just for that person, but for you, and its own kind of like coming back full cycle heat of a universal connection of extension of healing, giving of healing, extension of healing, giving of healing, and being able to release resentment, pains, even if you're not doing the talking. Them doing the talking with you is still shifting those feelings out, because you are accepting it in that view shift. Amara, come on. And delighting in that and seeing it as an ideal course of action and how to handle certain situations like this and how it's bringing a sense of gifts spiritually and emotionally to you as well. And more wisdom within this and being able to shift into feelings of the way of a sage and just giving an ear, giving an energy of release for someone, and how powerful of a position a sage gives by just listening, and how much it also shifts a healing inside yourself by playing this role. And how it's a wish come true, because it was over that. It's a wish come true for you. It shifts into a spontaneous wish come true for you, and to nurture your haste and impulsiveness when it comes to like jumping into things. You're going to be able to really feel motivation, growth, and joy, and rebirth into new beginnings with yourself and seeing it around you because of it shifting inside of yourself. But do also remember, give yourself patience into this shift, because you can't force this shift upon you. You can try to force healing all you want, but these ideal shifts and change in view, perspective, and mindsets come in its own pure timing when it's meant to come in for you to gain its full understanding. I have been in a position to where I've worked hard and so hard and keep going and working at my spiritual growth to really kind of try to step into this shift, until I literally just accepted things and just kind of walked through things with a sense of not holding on to thoughts that go through my head, not trying to control things that are going on around me, just experience it. And this is how I finally shifted into this. It shifts itself for you. Not you trying to shift it. I feel that's where kind of like, it's like it could have been prolonged until I naturally come to it, but at the same time I feel everything happens for a reason in its own right timing for certain understandings. So I feel that it happened at the right time, the way it was meant to happen within its own happening, because of just being aware of it. It's asking you to just be aware of what's going on within yourself and around you, and to keep calmness and peace in it. Step in when it's needed to step in, when you feel that push to step in, but listen. I feel it's a very big lesson of listening for you, and not just other people around you, but listening to these emotions being triggered inside of you, and kind of talking to yourself about these emotions that are being triggered inside of you, and being open more with it, not holding on to things in your head too much, and really learning the lesson of release within it, because I feel like you feel that releasing is something you have to work to just let go. But I have come to see in this state that releasing is just being aware as to what's going on, allowing yourself to project your feelings when it's needed, a word when it's needed, within your own self when you're pushed to do it, okay? When you feel in your heart to expand out, you know, to say something, when you feel you need, you are being asked to say something, not just like feeling a need to do it, but when you feel in your consciousness that, okay, it's time. And so you extend. And not to hold on to the thoughts of whether you did it right or whether it should have been done differently, but to just be aware of how maybe it was asking you to do things differently. Oh, Mara, it's okay. It's okay. That was weird. I shouldn't usually do that. No, she's having an attitude. That's what's going on. Okay. It's yeah. Release it, Amara. Release that aggravation. Jesus, and you're groaning. I've never seen a dog do that. Laying down, just going. Oh. The sitting and experiencing it. I'm not trying to analyze it too much. I'm just allowing it to be for what it is and enjoying it for what it is. She's also kind of like mumbling, barking. Like she's talking, like she's having an attitude about it. Like she's just lay down. Oh my gosh. I can't believe I got this on camera. Now she's having a fit. And then laying back down. She is having a fit about it. I feel like you're coming into a sense of being able to just she's laying back down and start just groaning about what's going on. Relax and laying back. Oh, poor girl. It is okay.
It is going to be okay, Mara. It's okay. She's okay. Easy.
Alright. It's like I feel like you're falling into trust that even though some things may happen the way it happens, it's like you're gonna just observe it more instead of trying to control it and listen in your emotions and your heart about how to go about it in a more accepting way of feeling and with your heart, and whoa. Last week, I swear this song played, but I was listening to Nightcore's version. I feel you may be having some issues about possibly letting go of someone you really care for, and it's asking you to heal this issue with your heart and to handle it more with an unconditional, loving, and compassionate way, no matter the outcome. Even if you don't want to let go. It's like I feel like you're going to allow it to be released. It's a very beautiful picture. Coming out of the shadows. Coming out of the shadows. Allowing your heart to be expressed. Thank you so much for watching. I greatly appreciate all of y'all. Don't forget to like and subscribe for more of my videos. I hear you. I know. It's just horrible, isn't it? I get it. All right. And thank you all of you for viewing. I greatly appreciate it. Thank you all of you for your subscriptions. I greatly, greatly appreciate it. And if you would like a personal reading with me to better hone in on just your energies, the information is below. And if you would love to donate to my channel, that would be greatly appreciated, and the information is below as well. All right, Sagittarius, I will see y'all next week. Goodbye, Unicorn Owl.